Machine learning-driven exoskeleton. Researchers from the Stanford Biomechatronics Laboratory have created machine learning-powered exoskeleton boots, which are robotics built in labs and allow wearers to move faster and easier while using less energy. The robotic boots have a motor that is connected to the muscles in the calf to provide the wearer with a boost for every step. Unlike other exoskeletons out there, this push is personalized thanks to a machine learning-based AI model that was trained through years of work using emulators. On a treadmill, the device provides twice the energy savings of previous exoskeletons. In the real world, this translates to significant energy savings and walking speed improvements. The main goal is to aid people with mobility issues to move around the world in the way they prefer, especially those who are older. With this breakthrough, researchers believe this technology can be commercialized and miniaturized within the next few years. The first time the user puts on an exoskeleton can be a bit of an adjustment, but after about 15 minutes of walking, it becomes quite natural. The exoskeleton's movement is like having an extra bounce in your stride and provides a noticeable increase in comfortability. The biggest obstacle to successful exoskeletons in the past was the need for individualization. Most exoskeletons were designed using a combination of intuition or biomimicry, but people's sizes and movements are too complicated and diverse. To tackle the issue, the research team used a large exoskeleton emulator lab setup, which quickly determined the best ways to help individuals and uncovered the blueprints for effective portable devices to be used in the field. When students and volunteers were connected to the emulators, researchers recorded their energy expenditure and motion data to determine how walking with the exoskeleton affected the user's energy output. The resulting data showed the different advantages of various types of aid provided through the simulator and was fed into a machine learning model to individually optimize the exoskeleton for each user. The exoskeleton can speed up the pace of walking by applying torque to the ankle and replaces certain functions of the calf muscles. When users take a step in the direction of their toes, right before they are poised to walk, the device assists them in pushing their foot off the ground. The artificial intelligence component then tunes the exoskeleton to provide a slightly different walking pattern depending on the user's size and speed. When it is able to measure the movement, the machine learning model determines the best way to aid the user each time they step. The researchers discovered that the exoskeleton allowed users to walk 9% faster and with the use of 17% less energy for each mile traveled. High-resolution wearable electro-tactile rendering device to simulate sense of touch in the metaverse. A team of researchers led by City University of Hong Kong has created a wearable tactile rendering system to provide long distance and simulated touch with large spatial resolution and rapid response. The team showed its potential through a braille display that adds the feeling of touch in the metaverse to perform functions like gaming and shopping in virtual reality, as well as possibly helping deep-sea divers, astronauts, and other workers who must wear gloves that are extremely thick. Although there has been great progress in developing sensors that digitally capture tactile features with high resolution and high sensitivity, we still lack a system that can effectively virtualize the sense of touch that can record and playback tactile sensations over space and time. Working in collaboration with Chinese Tencent's Robotics X Laboratory, the team created a unique electro-tactile rendering technique to provide diverse tactile sensations. The results were published in the scientific journal Science Advances. The methods used to recreate tactile sensations can be divided into two categories: electrostimulation and mechanical. Mechanical devices are used when you apply a localized force or vibration to the surface of the skin. While these mechanical devices are able to produce continuous and stable tactile sensations, they can weigh a lot, which can limit their resolution when used in the form of a wearable device. Electro-tactile stimulators trigger sensations of touch within the skin with electrodes that send an electric current through the skin. They are lightweight and flexible, while offering better resolution and quicker response. However, the majority of these depend on high-voltage direct current impulses, which can be up to several hundred volts, in order to enter the topmost layer of the skin to stimulate nerves and receptors. Previously, this could be dangerous and lack high resolution, but the most recent electro-tactile actuator designed by the team of researchers is thin, flexible, and safe. It easily fits into the finger cot, and the device provides a host of different tactile sensations, including pressure, vibration, and roughness, all with very high resolution. Instead of DC pulses, the team devised an alternating stimulation technique that is high frequency and was able to reduce the operating voltage to 30 volts, which ensures that the tactile display is both comfortable and safe. They also suggested a new super resolution method that allows tactile sensations in areas between electrodes too. This improves the resolution of their spatial stimulators by more than 300% and provides the user with a truly amazing and lifelike sense of touch. The new system can elicit tactile stimuli with a very high degree of spatial resolution at 76 dots per centimeter squared, which is similar to the density of related receptors in the human skin and a rapid response rate of 4 kHz. The team performed a variety of tests to illustrate the different ways to use this wearable, electro-tactile rendering technology. For instance, they suggested an innovative braille method that is simpler for those who have a visual impairment. The new method splits the numerals and the alphabet into distinct strokes and sequences, exactly the way the letters are written. Wearing the electro-tactile rendering device on the fingertip, the wearer is able to recognize the alphabet displayed by detecting the direction and sequence of strokes by using their fingertip. This would be particularly useful for people who lose their eyesight later in life, allowing them to continue to read and write using the same alphabetic system, without the need to learn the whole braille dot system. The second use case is for games and applications that use virtual reality and augmented reality, bringing the sensation of touch to the virtual world. The electrodes are both flexible and expandable, meaning they can cover larger areas, such as the palm of one's hand. The researchers showed that users can feel the texture of clothing in a virtual shop. The users could also feel an itchy sensation on their fingers when they were kissed by a VR cat. While stroking a real cat's fur, users will feel a change in the roughness when strokes shift in direction, as well as speed. The system is also beneficial in transmitting fine tactile information through thick gloves. The team was able to integrate these light, thin electrodes into a safety glove. The sensor array detects the distribution of pressure on the outside of the glove and then relays the data to the user in real time by triggering the user's senses. In the test, the participant was able to swiftly and precisely locate tiny steel washers that were just 1 millimeter in radius and 0.44 millimeters thick by using the tactile feedback that the glove provided via its sensors and stimulation. The system's capabilities are evident and can provide high-quality tactile feedback, which is currently inaccessible to firefighters, astronauts, and deep-sea divers who must wear heavy gloves and protective suits. This technology could benefit a broad spectrum of applications, such as information transmission, surgical training, teleoperation, and multimedia entertainment.